through tears, Kurush Dushanash is fighting for justice for his late fiancée.
She was a beautiful, smart, very accomplished scientist.
That is where my research comes in.
Dr. Farou Hadem was on Ukrainian Airlines Flight 752 when it was shot out of the sky in January. The award-winning scientist was one of six from Canada chosen to attend a Nobel laureate meeting and had planned to get married this summer.
She was love of my life. I never imagined at this stage of my life I'm going to find someone so beautiful and so loving, and then to be snatched is brutally.
Dushanash simply doesn't believe a new report from Iran's Civil Aviation Organization. It blames the catastrophic tragedy on a misaligned missile battery and communication between soldiers and their commanders.
This is continuation of the lies and deceit they have been doing. And we don't believe to anything what they say because they are not credible.
Former Foreign Affairs Minister Lloyd Axworthy says the report must be challenged. But he says that won't be easy because Canada cut ties with Iran in 2012, something he says needs to change.
When we're not there, we're simply relying upon other governments to do the lifting for us. And I think that's why it's important to get involved.
Dushanash grew up in Iran and doesn't trust the government. He says it has harassed relatives of victims who died on board in recent months.
We have people even in Canada. They are receiving threatening phone calls.
Iran now says it will transfer the plane's black boxes to France. Investigators from Canada as well as other countries are going to be there next week to see if any data can be retrieved and to see if it says anything new. Austin Grabish, CBC News, Winnipeg.